Now, unit testing the pure way, or the pure functional programming way, is that you have nothing but functions, no classes, and same input, same output every single time with no side effects. That's not necessarily how React works in the real world. Sometimes everything you're doing is not always these wonderful material design components. For example, they could be third-party charting components or old-school jQuery things that you're not even in charge of. And so you have to use a lot of the React lifecycle events to deal with them, such as the component did mount and dealing with really deeply nested components, should it render or re-render, those kind of things. You still have cases where you're not going to use something like Recompose, for example, and you're still going to have to extend React component. But you can make it what they call pushing the side effects far to the side as possible. What we can do is we can extract those functions into pure functions. So let me give an example. You'll notice that on username blur is no longer here. I've extracted it out of the class. So now we have a pure function that's actually exported along with the class as well. And so on our top of our unit test, we can import it alongside of the class. It's the default export. We can now test this function in isolation. We don't even have to know that it's associated with any React component. We can test it by itself with its own inputs, same outputs, and it doesn't affect the outside world anywhere. Very, very great isolation, and we can use that to target exactly what's going wrong in this function, and we know if it works, we put it elsewhere, it'll work fine. Part of the solution, not part of the problem. Once we go into the stateful world, which is a little harder to debug, right, because all these things sometimes require more manual testing, we at least know that this is a lot more solid. But you can probably see a problem. And that is that most event handlers inside of React always take one and only one parameter. And that's from the UI controls. Specifically, if I click on something, it's going to be the mouse event. If I type in a text field, it's going to be the keyboard event or whatever React events might be augmented. There's no such thing as self. There's no such thing as like, we're going to pass in this, right? So there's no this, right? So we have to pass it in as self. And I'm using my abstraction because if I did this, the state wouldn't return anything, so this would have no return value. So we don't know if the function works. We still have to use my state abstraction. And this applies not just to React, but any function that doesn't return a value. You can really augment them really easy doing this. But we still have this two-parameter problem. So what do? And how is that affected? If you go down to where we wire this stuff up, instead of JSX, you'll notice that it's no longer this not username blur. This on blur function is going to call this with one and only parameter called event. And there's no this at all inside of the onUsername blur. It's literally a function. It's not attached to a class at all. Is change it and say, all right, well, we'll go ahead and give you the this as the first parameter, but we can't give it the event until it's called. So if this returns a function with the this already baked in, then onBlur will call it later whenever you click on it or tab away from it with the event. How do we do that? Well, if you want a function that takes partially applied parameters or arguments to it and gives you a function back, you can create a function partial. The easiest way to do that is using curry. Now, I like curry n, but I'm just going to use curry for the sake of simplicity here. And that means that when I call this function with one parameter, it's going to give me a function back. This on username blur, if you call it like this, with this baked in, baked, Jesse, not backed. This isn't Kickstarter. If we pass in this, it'll give us a function back, and now this is going to take one parameter, which is the event, and we're good to go. So how do we get this to work? Well, this is exactly what's happening down in our JSX, except this value right here is stored inside of the React binding. So that's what we've done below. We've got a curried function here. We can call it, and you'll notice we treat the unit test for it the same way. We pass it a stubbed set state, and if we call set state with a value, we want the same value back. It just so happens that that's called the identity function in category theory, and identity comes with Lodash. So if we call set state with an O, I want to get the O back. Tell me what that is. And so onBlur will handle that. The second parameter is the events. So we just do it just like we did up here in the DOM. We give it a fake event, and it comes back. And so now with two lines of code instead of three, you'll notice there's no component to create. There's no enzyme wrapper around it, no React, nothing. It's literally just testing pure functions. Same inputs give you the same outputs. So very similar test to the above. If something breaks, we can target that function specifically. That, ladies and gentlemen, is how you use pure functions inside of React by still being pragmatic and allowing those classes to be there. And you get around this problem using curried functions, which create partial applications, so you can use those to bind in your JSX. And this kind of stuff is super, super common if you're doing a lot of the non-stateful components, just really dumb components, right? Same input, same output. They can bind to these things out internally. So then suddenly your entire file is a bunch of functions.